In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning to you all. Welcome. It's nice to have congregation to greet and to interact with, as well as those who join us for our Mass today on our YouTube channel. On this Sunday, when congregations return to churches to celebrate together the gift of prayer as we celebrate our Mass. It's been a long time since we were able to do so, and the number of weeks have gone by quick, and yet there is, we hope, a sense of great joy as we return. And as things begin to return cautiously to what we have known in the past, and how we can readjust or readapt to how things are in the present. And as we come together this morning in prayer, and knowing that the gift of God's presence is among us, He is the one, through the humility of His love, who comes to be with us, to help us in our need, to carry our burdens with us, and to assist us. So, gathered in the presence of the Lord, in that prayerfulness, united, both here present and with those who join us in Mass elsewhere, we begin our prayer and we ask the Lord for His pardon and forgiveness as we prepare to celebrate our Mass. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary of a Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. O God, who in the abasement of your Son have raised up a fallen world, fill your faithful with holy joy. For on those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal gladness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the prophet Zechariah. The Lord says this, "Rejoice, heart and soul, daughter of Zion. Shout with gladness, daughter of Jerusalem. See now your king comes to you. He is victorious. He is triumphant, humble and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. He will banish chariots from Ephraim and horses from Jerusalem. The bow of war will be banished. He will proclaim peace for the nations. His empire shall stretch from sea to sea, from the river to the ends of the earth." The word of the Lord. The responsorial psalm is, "I will bless your name forever, O God, my King. I will give you glory, O God, my King. I will bless your name forever. I will bless you day after day and praise your name forever. I will bless your name forever, O God, my King. The Lord is kind and full of compassion, slow to anger, abounding in love. How good is the Lord to all, compassionate to all his creatures. I will bless your name forever, O God, my King. All your creatures shall thank you, O Lord, and your friends shall repeat their blessing. They shall speak of the glory of your reign and declare your might, O God. I will bless your name forever, O God, my King. The Lord is faithful in all his words and loving in all his deeds. The Lord supports all who fall and raises all who are bowed down. I will bless your name forever, O God, my King. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Your interests are not in the unspiritual, but in the spiritual, since the Spirit of God has made his home in you. In fact, unless you possessed the Spirit of Christ, you would not belong to him. And if the Spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead is living in you, then he who raised Jesus from the dead will give life to your own mortal bodies through his Spirit living in you. So then, my brothers, there is no necessity for us to obey our unspiritual selves or to live unspiritual lives. If you do live in that way, you are doomed to die. But if by the Spirit you put an end to the misdeeds of the body, you will live. The word of the Lord.
You are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a people set apart to sing the praises of God, who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus exclaimed, I bless you, Father, Lord of heaven and of earth, for hiding these things from the learned and the clever and revealing them to mere children. Yes, Father, for that is what it pleased you to do. Everything has been entrusted to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, just as no one knows the Father except the Son and those to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are overburdened, and I will give you rest. Shoulder my yoke and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. Yes, my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord. I'm sure we all have experienced different kinds of burden over the past number of weeks and in these times. Where do they come from? We might often discover that our burdens are of our own making, or we might think they're put upon us by other people. But does that cause us to change our way of living, our attitude? How do we address them, and in what way do we find the strength to overcome or to maybe accept our burdens that we may need to accept? Jesus comes, as he says, to help us carry these burdens. It is through the gift of his humility, the humility of God, the Almighty Father's Son, who has come into the world to help us and assist us carry our burden. There's something that doesn't fit very right when Jesus proclaims that he is the King of all heaven and earth, and yet he is the one who is most humble, humble that, as the prophet in the first reading says, rides on a donkey. That's the gift of God's word. The contradiction is that it achieves its greatness through humility, gentleness, and compassion. That carrying the burden alongside is the way through which we discover something of the gift and strength of our lives. I'm sure in so many different ways throughout the last great number of weeks, and maybe continue for all of us, because life, as we know, has changed in so many ways that we have been challenged. We have struggled with the ways that have been cast upon us. Significant experiences have happened to us during the times, and they are definitely burdens that we have to carry. But as we come together to celebrate our prayer, I hope we can find that there's a great gift that we haven't lost or hasn't changed. That's the gift of God's presence. It's happily coincidental that the gospel today is a gospel of wonderful warmth and encouragement and inclusion. Jesus gives these words to us from the depths of his own compassion and kindness. It's words we would wish to utter to one another when life is difficult and when we experience hardship. Come to me, I will help you. I want to give you rest, comfort, assistance, and hope. All the words that we need to rebuild us and replenish that which may seem to be lost or diminished in our lives. So Jesus, from the greatness of his being, tells us that it is in the simplicity and humility, a childlike simplicity and humility, that we can discover, we can know and experience the gift of God's love. And it's also how we share and live that gift of God's love to one another. No doubt, the weeks ahead, as we hopefully build and restore that which is our somewhat of normal practices and gatherings together, our familiarity, that there will be a rebuilding of that great gift and joy of being present to celebrate in prayer. It may take a little time to return to what we have known in the past, but that's to be expected, for we've all experienced that, I suppose, uncertainty and nervousness or anxiety even about our movements and about our engagement with things on the outside world again. But we pray that that continues to grow in confidence and with security and with care for each other, as we do here, as in everywhere else where we gather and move in the public domain. So may that comforting presence of God be with us, that we come to him with our burdens, assured of his care and love for us, to assist us, to guide us, to build within us that gift of his great kindness and peace and love and hope for one another and for the future at this time. So let us now make our profession of faith. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things, visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. Look forward to the resurrection of the dead, life of the world to come. Trusting in the generous compassion of the Father, we turn to the Lord in prayer and voice our petitions.
For the Church, that God will help us take up the yoke of Christ and follow him in speaking and truth, the truth lovingly, offering forgiveness to those who wrong us and praying for our enemies. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the grace to be childlike, that we may learn dependence upon God and surrender our attempts to control our lives through knowledge, power, or possessions. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For freedom from fear, that God will help us surrender our fear and anxiety into the hands of the one who loves us and strengthen our confidence. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all those who are weary in body, mind, or spirit, that the Spirit will restore strength to the physically exhausted, hope to those who are emotionally worn out, and energy to all who are exhausted through loving service of others. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all who do not believe in God, that the Spirit will lead them into an encounter with the living God and help them to be open to the one who loves them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For an end to injustice and discrimination, that God will change the hearts and minds of those entrapped in judging people by externals and help everyone to recognize the God-given dignity of each person. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. We include now our own special intentions in our Mass today. Lord, hear us. For all the faithful departed, this morning in our Mass, we remember especially in prayer Declan Hodge, Louis Regan, Maisie and Jim O'Sullivan, Father Joe Dolan, member of the Columban Society, Tom Burke, whose anniversaries are around this time. May these and all who have gone before us be united in praise and in the presence of God in his eternal kingdom. Lord, hear us. Loving Father, we praise you with all our heart, for you have rescued us. Preserve us, protect us, change our mourning into dancing, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. O Lord, may this offering dedicated to your name purify us, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the life of heaven, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the host of angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who loved the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present among us when we are gathered by his love. And when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask you to send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and gave you thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the offering of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that, by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis, our Pope, and Tom, our Bishop, and Michael, our retired Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ and all the dead, whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with her spouse Saint Joseph, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty, Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. With hope and confidence, we pray to our Heavenly Father as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done in earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, the glory are yours now. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. For receiving Holy Communion, if you just come up through the center aisle in two lines to both ministers and extend your hands fully to receive communion, and then you can return down by the side to your places. Let us pray. O Lord, grant, we pray, that having been replenished by such great gifts, we may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you through Christ our Lord. So in our Mass today, we remember especially in prayer Declan Hodge, Louis Regan, Maisie and Jim O'Sullivan, Father Joe Dolan, and Tom Burke, whose anniversaries are around this time. And also we include prayer for Mary Sheehan from Cork, who died during the week. She is sister of Jean Buckley of Kilgraig. And Father Paddy Keary, whose funeral took place earlier this week. He was priest in the parish here back in 1988 until 1991, remembered and loved by many. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord. May perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Just as we come to the end of our Mass again, to welcome all who join us here this morning in our church in Kilcloon and those who join us through the airwaves for our Mass, I have to announce sadly that today is the last Sunday on which we will be able to broadcast our Mass. The contract was undertaken to have Mass broadcast while the church was closed and unable to have congregations, and during that time it's been a great blessing and comfort to many, and even for myself, to be able to know and feel that contact with people who are not present with us here in the church. So through the weeks it's been, it was something of great value and grace that I've appreciated, and I think without the help of many people that wouldn't have been possible. So I'd just like to say a big thank you and much appreciation to the team that was able to coordinate and organize that for us here in the parish. Most of all to Ciarán for setting up the equipment for us, and for Paul and John for operating each and every week, both here in Kilcloon and Batterstown in different locations that we had through those weeks and which people enjoyed. And it was a great amount of work, and well done to all that team and to support and help for that. And to those who were available to us through the weeks for the ministries of music and reading and different supports that we needed, organizing and keeping the churches well and looking very presentable and beautiful. So work went on ahead, even despite there wasn't that facility of people to come and join us in the churches. Things kept going well. So much appreciation and many thanks to all for that great kindness and support during those weeks, and for those who have joined us over the weeks and have made contact and given words of appreciation and thanks and gratitude. It meant a great deal. So we hope that in due course we will be able to return with confidence to celebrating together in our church here in Kilcloon. And for those who come to join us in the Masses, I know that you need to come feeling comfortable and secure and safe, and we appreciate that. We hope therefore that the help and team that have organized the church and made it safe and clean and usable at this time, that everybody will feel that comfort and support and security and safe coming to Mass. And therefore, just as you see that the supports that are there available to us are hand sanitizers, after our Mass this morning and each time we have a gathering in the church, we will clean the building. There's a gadget for sanitizing the place so that those who come to Mass at a later time will know that they enter the church that is clean and free to use without any risk or caution about it. No doubt it's nice to see one another face to face and have a word or two, but just to remember that as we enter or leave the church, we give space to people in front of us that they will exit safely, and we don't wish to see gatherings or congregations that would maybe leave others feeling anywhere nervous. It's just for everybody's well-being and safety. So if we remember that, then we will do things well. So for these things we're getting used to in all public places, and as we go about our daily lives, they are part of what we do now, but we just do it with care and caution for each other. Also, just to note that toilets are available in the parish centre for use while Masses are taking place in the church. And this coming week, we will have on Friday the ceremonies for confirmation. So if you see gatherings here at the church, you know what's going on. Bishop Deanahan will attend on Friday for two ceremonies of confirmation for the school classes from Scoil Oliver Naefa, Rathregan and Mulhussy. And it's great to be able to undertake and have those ceremonies available and celebrate in the parish. Over the next couple of Sundays, we will have our first Holy Communion ceremonies at individual masses also for the schools in the parish. So I know these have been somehow, well, I won't say deprived, but the usual celebrations and excitement haven't been able to take place this year, sadly. But no doubt they will still be looked forward to and enjoyed by all the families and candidates who receive their communion and confirmation over the coming time. So, may we have a good and a safe and a happy, contented week ahead and all that we have to do ahead of us. So we'll go and serve the Lord happily and with joy. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.